Hello, my little dolls, puppets, and action figures. Welcome back to another cute podcast. My name is Swarzy, and I will be your host today. This is my Chanel. I love her so much. She's so cute. I got her from Paris at 31 Rue Cambeau, which is the flagship store. She has these little wreaths and letters on the top. She's so precious, so gorgeous. We're just gonna have her have a seat over here. I am the author of Dear Diary, Genius Downloads by Cute Doll. I literally wrote a book. It's on Amazon. It's linked at the top of my page. Thank you to my first purchaser yesterday. It took me 9 days to sell my first book, and I'm very proud of this because I'm really grateful. I know some people never even sell their books, and just that you guys bought my first book, it was amazing. So it was published on August 17th, but I really didn't tell anybody about it until the next day. So August 18th is when I told all my viewers about my book. It took 9 days and I got my first sale, and I'm very grateful. Whoever you are out there, please rate me 5 stars on Amazon.com and only leave me a nice review. Keep all of your other comments, critical feedback, and suggestions, and everything like that else to yourself. And also don't tell anybody what's in my book. Thank you. Although you are not able to see my user ratings because I hid them on all of my videos and all of my shorts, please hit the like button, give this video a thumbs up. It still helps the algorithm and it helps more people find me, and it still helps the video a lot. Even though you can't see it, it's invisible to you, I can still get a really good result from you pressing thumbs up. So make sure that you press thumbs up after watching all of my videos. While I was editing my videos, I noticed I always stand like this and like this a lot. I got this from cheerleading. So whenever we're in like our position where we're moving from one move to another, we have to stand like this. I forgot what it's called, but I always tuck my hands like behind my thighs like this. Oh, and it's so comfortable. That's why I'm always like this posture. It has been ingrained in me early on. Are you all having dreams of me now because you keep watching my podcast, my podcast, and my twitch.tv/cutedoll? You know, whenever you see someone a lot, sometimes maybe you start dreaming of them. So this is how I take my sea moss. I take 3 teaspoons. This is what she looks like. Very viscous. Nutrients. You can find this one on cutedollhouse.com at the top of my page. Everything I'm using today is linked in my Amazon storefront, and follow for more. Very healthy for you. I have this every morning. This next thing I'm going to make, my sister actually showed me how to make this. So year was 2021, and my sister sent me a package, and she said, I want you to try this. And she told me how to make this. And afterward, I ordered it maybe like 3 more times. But then I just kind of forgot about it. But I have it now. And she's linked in my Amazon storefront all of the ingredients I'm using today. So you can make one along with me. Just rewatch the video. Okay, so it actually has the a separate recipe in the back too. Okay, this is the fun part. That's dangerous. Give me a second. First step is to open it. It's like super hard to open because it's don't put too much. Then you take a little bit of lime. I just do like 2 squirts. 1, 2. It's also linked to my Amazon storefront. I think it's amazing that all the ingredients are conveniently on Amazon. And then you take some cayenne pepper. By the way, I got this cup in Holland when I went to TwitchCon Europe. I just swirl it. So delicious. Not really, but it's good for you. I know I'm very persuasive. Oh, and mine is so spicy because I put so much cayenne pepper, plus the ginger. Lost the line. But we're doing this every day. It's very spicy, so be careful. It feels like it's medicine. Did you guys see my new video edits? No final fantasy, can we end these games though? You give me energy, make me feel like... Make sure that you grab the Nerea sweatpants and crop top out of the store before it goes out of the shop. It's limited. Also, I'm going to be playing Thymine for the first time this week. So if you can, on one of your alts or on your main, please join my Legion raid for Thymine and help me clear the dungeon for the very first time this week. I'm so excited to go in. I have no idea what it looks like, and I'm about to do research on it and raid lead that Legion raid. I'm really looking forward to Thymine because when it was launched, it was a huge deal, and there were achievements and medals, and everyone was talking about it. There was such great hype, and the whole entire theme was Thymine themed for Lost Ark, so yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. I know I'm kind of late to the party, but I don't feel really late at all. I'm just going at my own pace, and I'll be doing Thymine normal, and when I feel like I'll be ready and that I'll have enough gold and mats to upgrade my character and that I'm ready to like make the commitment, then I will go for 1620 and try to do the Kazaros raid. But for now, I'm trying just to do Thymine this week. So please do help me clear that dungeon. I'm sure everyone's really good at it by now. And I'm really excited to be the raid leader. Really excited to research a new raid. It's gonna feel like a whole new game for me. It's gonna feel like a whole new territory, and I'm really looking forward to it very much. I'm about to go have my electrolytes. These are linked to my Amazon store friends. But the last thing I want to tell you is to make sure that you get the Pixel weapon skin in the shop before it leaves the shop. I bought it for almost all my characters, and I also bought some backup ones just in case in my product storage. I wanted to let you know something. So when you dye it, the color that the pixel animation is, if it's teal or magenta, that color you can't change of the animation, the glowing little particles of my like staff glowing. But the real staff, the rest of the staff, you can change. It's a really cute skin. It looks like Legos. It's very adorable. But I recommend that you get the teal set. And be very careful, because if you buy the wrong one, you can't dye it and you'll have like a glowing pink thing, and I actually don't like that shade of pink yet, so you never know with me. Ever changing. That actually wraps it up for today's podcast. I also just want to show you my outfit before I go. So today's outfit is really cute. It has like this very soft cotton pink, and somehow I managed to have this set match perfectly even though they were not purchased together. So the top is crocheted, and it even has these beautiful little rosettes crocheted on top of it with a nice little crisscross yarn in the middle. And I like this like crochet feeling. It really helps bring me into autumn. I feel like it helps like bring the cozy weather, even though it's really warm outside right now. Also, my skirt has ruffles, and the ruffles are white. It has two layers of ruffles. It reminds me of a little cake. I love that it's hip hugger. I grew up with hip huggers. Those were normal when I was growing up. I didn't really realize when they were doing high-waisted jeans in 2021, and I didn't really realize that a different style was like coming into my closet. I was kind of wondering why I didn't really like those shorts I was buying in 2021. They were all high-waisted or like right here, and they just do not fit me properly because I have an hourglass figure, and I'm also used to wearing hip huggers ever since I was a teenager. One of my favorite store when I was a kid, my parents used to take us to Green Acres Mall, and I used to go to 579 with my sisters. My dad used to buy us everything we all wanted, and my mom used to help us pick out clothes. And we'd be in the changing rooms and trying on all of these cute little teen tween clothes. It was so cute. But all my hip hugger stuff, all my jeans were hip huggers. Everything was hip huggers, so it goes with my figure. So I'm just so happy finally. I really am on the hunt for hip hugger skirts. You see me trying my best. but yeah, I love that it's hip hugger. It makes me so nostalgic, and I love the fit. And I love these little bow details on the top. I adore that style. I actually prefer to have like a cami strap instead of having a strapless or halter. Halter, even if it's light, it always like makes me my posture different, and I don't really like how it makes me feel overall. So I don't prefer halter tops at all, even though they are cuter. I just have an issue wearing them. But when I was growing up, I had a lot of halter tops. It was like really in to have like halters, wear halter. So yeah, I like this, like cami crop tops and cute skirts. I also got some shorts. Like I got a red and white picnic plaid short with a white bow. Maybe I'll wear it sometime. But then I also have some brand deals coming up, and I'll be wearing all their clothes and linking the products if you guys want to buy them. Good news, they're all like Halloween and cozy themed, so I'm looking forward to that. Just waiting for the merchandise to get here. Do I have anything new and up and coming for you guys? I just really, all day today, all I wanted to do was just get on my stream. I've been long awaiting, like I did my TikTok. Just now, I think this dance is so cute. And I just really have been waiting for to just stream today. And last night I actually wanted to play League a little, but at 3 a.m. when the servers were closed, I was planning to play League of Legends, but I got really tired, so I just decided to sleep instead. Yeah. If there are any lost ark sharks, whales out there that would like to do a meet and greet or get to know me in the New York East area, DM me on Instagram or Discord, whichever you prefer. I would love to have like some cookies or something, and coffee, I don't know. I haven't had coffee in a while, but it's not like I'm against it. Coffee's pretty fun. Also, did anybody try the pumpkin spice caramel crunch latte from Starbucks? I'm not trying it, but someone please try it for me and let me know how delicious it is. Because if you know me from the old days, you know I'm a crazy big Starbucks fan. next. Did anybody get a new iPhone? I'm like dying to get a new iPhone right now. But I'm afraid as soon as I get one, they're just gonna like come out with another one, which happens. So I'm like just trying to find out, like, I need to be persuaded. Like, I need someone to tell me, like, yes, the camera is so good or whatever. Like, I really want to get a new iPhone so bad. I'm trying to find an excuse. So DM me, let me know how the new iPhones are. Or maybe there's a different phone. I don't know. I've been an iPhone girly since I was 18. I had the first generation iPhone when I was 18 years old. It was given to me by my dad as a gift for going to college. And I had the first generation iPhone. I wish I kept it, but I didn't. I wish I kept all my iPhone generations, but somehow they were just got lost, thrown out, or recycled throughout the years. And when the trade-in program started and I had the opportunity to trade in, I did trade in. So, yeah. But that's all I have for you guys today. My perfume and my chapstick line are gonna be at cutedollhouse.com again. So watch out for the new flavors that I'm releasing this fall. I'm really excited. I wanna let you know that my perfume is safe for skin and hair, and it's made with really good products, like as little preservatives and as little chemicals as possible. And I wanna say no chemicals. My chapstick is flavored, and it's also scented, and they're all so good. Like, it's all I use. For the chapstick, there's two sizes, the small one and the large one. I like the big one because I'm like extra, like I have to have a huge chapstick, like just putting it on. But honestly, I recommend the small one. I think it's more convenient, it lasts a really long time, and plus then you get to sample all the flavors and see which one you like and get those. If you don't know which one to get, for each of those, for the perfume, I would get vanilla for him. It's unisex though, I do not use it. And for the chapstick, I would get vanilla. I think vanilla is very safe, it's very nostalgic, it's very season friendly. And yeah, but I do have more creative gourmand scents and flavors. Just keep checking back and you will see the update go through and you will be able to purchase them. And thank you guys for all of your support so far. I really appreciate everybody, even the people that are spamming emotes in the chat and the people that are watching my YouTube, my TikToks, the people that are following me on Instagram at cutedoll, the people that are watching my Twitch show. Rolling live right now, by the way, twitch.tv/cutedoll, and the people that help me with all my raids, and people that are doing even more stuff that I can't even see. Thank you all. I love you. And get ready, because Halloween's gonna be here in a blink. Okay, bye.